Sumo Logic monitors allow you to set robust and configurable alerting policies. These policies enable you to get notified about critical changes or issues affecting your dev, test, and production applications. Sumo Logic allows you to monitor metrics, traces, and logs in real time using a single pane of glass. It enables all of your teams, including your developers, operations, security, and business groups, to come together and view their data in the same context. I am Odell Gordon, and today I will demonstrate to you how to add a metric-based monitor. I am already logged into my Sumo Logic environment. I'll go over to the navigation pane and click on Manage Data. Under Manage Data, I'll click on Monitoring. Here, we can see all of the configured monitors. This is going to help us track our metrics or our logs data in real time and send us notifications when noteworthy changes happen in our applications. On the Monitors page, we'll click the Add button and select New Monitor. The monitor creation dialog box appears. As a monitor type, we will select metrics. We will leave our detection method set to static. Let's enter a query here. We can look at our historical trend and see that it's returning data values, indicating that our query is running. Over to the left of the query, you will notice that there are letter labels. Letter labels are to help you reference a query row. The monitor will automatically detect the query row that triggers your alert and will mark that row with a notification bell icon. Next, we can select and change our alert grouping. We want to get alerted on our metric that crosses a static threshold on our metrics query. We can set it by alert per monitor, by alert per field or fields, or by alert by time series. We will select the time series in this example. Now we go down to our trigger types. We have critical, warning, and missing data. Let's set up a threshold for our critical. Let's enable our alert. We want our results to be greater than a value. In this example, we'll type in 180. We want our alert to happen at all times within a 15-minute period. We also want to set a warning. So we'll click on the warning tab. Enable our alert. Our alert, when results are greater than, we'll populate with a value of 170. And we also want this to happen within 15 minutes. Now, we can use our historical chart to look at the historical trends and help us figure out if a trigger threshold are configured correctly and can ensure that the alerts are not flaky. Scrolling down, advanced settings. These settings are optional. Over to the right, you'll see that you have the ability to show available variables. We have built-in variables as parameters that you can use to customize your JSON payload objects of your alert notifications. For example, you and I can use the alert response URL. This is going to allow us, when our monitor is triggered, it will generate a URL and provide it as the value of this variable where you can use it to open the alert. Next, we'll have our notifications, which is also an optional area. Here, we can group our notifications. We can get notified for multiple items. This is grouping. Or we can add a notification and create a notification for each individual connection type. Scrolling down further, lastly, we can name our monitor. We can optionally add a description. We can designate where this monitor is going to be saved. We can optionally add a playbook as well. Playbooks allow us as admins to codify tribal knowledge for an on-call engineer so they know what exactly to do when they receive an alert. Also, be aware that markdown language is supported. Lastly, after we save our monitor, we can, of course, search for it and find our monitor. And here we can click on the three dots of our monitor and disable it, as well as delete it. We suggest, if you follow along, that you disable or delete your monitor. I hope this video helps you create a metrics-based monitor using Sumo Logic. Thank you for joining.